Well, good afternoon, YouTube. Look at this. 12:30, and it's 30 degrees. And we're having a little ride out to go and see my dad in his caravan in Bridge North. But I'm going to stop first in Wolverley for a cheeky little ice cream. Just got back from Normandy. What a belting blast that was. Our first European tour. So I'd imagine, oh actually, I don't know actually, if you'll see this video before episode 2 comes out. Episode 1 was me talking about if the ferries were going to be cancelled. So episode 2 is premiering tonight, Friday the 31st at 8 p.m. And that's the episode of us travelling from home, meeting Albie and Escobar, and travelling down to Portsmouth where we had the travel lodge for the night. So this video might come out before that goes live tonight, I don't know. I don't think I will put up two videos in one night. I'll probably put this one up over the weekend or something. So yeah, so Normandy. So we left on the Thursday. Friday morning we got up early, got the ferry to Cannes, which was a 5.5 hour ferry. We didn't get there till 3 p.m. on the afternoon. By the time we got to our digs, it was about 5 o'clock. So we unpacked our stuff. We then headed into Carentan to have tea, take a few photos from the famous Carentan battle in Band of Brothers. So that was the Thursday and the Friday, already gone. Saturday was a full day's riding in Normandy, and so was the Sunday. Then early Monday morning, we was coming home. So really, we only had 2 full days riding in Normandy. And when I looked at Normandy on the map, and I thought, yeah, we'll go there. Holy schmoly. I didn't realise how big the place was. I mean, really, from our digs, everywhere I was going was an hour, right? Everything was an hour. So, what me and Albie did, me and Albie shared leading the group. So, me and Albie, we plotted out on the map all of the most famous places. And we thought, right, we'll get there. When we get to that point, we'll see what time it is. And we'll move on to the next one, whichever one we choose. So, we didn't have an exact schedule or itinerary to do. We just played it by ear, had it nice and easy. So I thought it was our first time abroad, our first time riding on the right-hand side of the road, apart from Albie and Escobar. Obviously Albie's been everywhere, he's done America. So, but for us, it was new. It was brand new. It was a massive experience for us. So we wanted the first one not to be too much of a pressured tour. We wanted to take it easy, chillax, kind of enjoy the time together and the company. So there was the 9 of us, and it was belting, absolutely brilliant. And Escobar, never met Escobar before. What a bloke he is, top bloke Escobar. And welcome to the Motourev family, Escobar. And Albie, oh, he's what a diamond geezer. But one big thanks I owe, and what is fully deserved. Excuse me, I've just swallowed a dune bug. Was Piggy. Now I know Piggy's new to us, and you're probably thinking, what did he do? Piggy is a bit like me, he loves his gadgets, his technology. And Piggy's got a proper camera. See, I'll just take the photos on the phone, but Piggy's got a proper camera. And he's got the new DJI drone. I mean, I took my drone with me. But Piggy was, whatever he was taking the photos, he'd got the drone up. And to be honest with you, that is drone work. Absolutely blows mine away. He is amazing with that drone. Where normally what I have to do, I have to like video my shot, move the camera, which is then all jittery and jolting, cut that bit out. When I'm on my next shot, he's then edit that part. Piggy, God, he'd just do it in one go, one swoop. He'd video everything smooth as butter. So Piggy, thanks mate for all the work you did on that tour. It was nice. Because it allowed me to take a step back. He said he'd be concentrated on the routes, the cameras, who's recording, the photographs, the drone. It allowed me to embrace the tour as well, which I've never done that before. And that, it was really, really nice. So, Piggy, all thanks to you, mate. And I can't wait to see you. I mean, so far, I have not seen, I'd say, 90% of the drone footage Piggy took. I saw a few bits when he did it and I says, no, I want to wait till I edit it to see that. So, I know as much as you about what the drone footage is like at the moment. I ain't got a clue what he's captured. But I know, a fact, it will be belting. So, we're pulling up at Wolverley now. I think I might have a cheeky little ice cream. So I'm about 3/4 of the way to my dad, but I did say to my dad, I am going to stop off on the way. Because I will be roasted. 31 degrees now. But I need to invest in a mesh jacket. I mean, this has got the vents in, but obviously inside this jacket is the waterproof membrane. So these air vents ain't doing nothing. And I'm absolutely barking. Yeah, so we're going to go and see the old man in his caravan. There's a pub at the bottom of the site at a biker's cafe. I'll go and take him for a pint. So I ain't seen him now actually with Normandy and weekends before we was camping. I probably ain't seen him now for about a good 4 weeks. So let's go and have a brew with him. Let's have a brew and a chat. It can't get any hotter than this 31. Surely it cannot. But anyhow, on holiday a week tomorrow down to St Ives, so if the weather's like this, it will be busting. Well, let's pull up here. Let's get a cheeky little ice cream. Couple of bikes here already. We will have this spot. Jesus, it's hot. Holy Christ. Christ on a bike. Christ on a bike. Right. Let's go and have myself a cheeky little ice cream. Might send the drone up here, actually. There's a lovely church over there. I don't know if you can see it. Lovely church up there. Might be able to drone it. I wonder if MLC are here. MLC, is that his? But now, did he have a tracer? No, I'm sure he didn't. Right, bye bye for now. Thank you. Well then, let's go and see Dad. Here we are. Let's have a look at the view. Oh, you can see the river.
Yeah.
I bet you can see that when it floods as well.
Yeah, you can. Oil in the field on the other
side. Going for a little cheeky drink at the pub, I think. Obviously just a Coke. Look at that sky. Look at that sky. Let me dress Gof.
Come here, okay.
You ready for the disco? Let's go and have a drink. Yeah. Oh, that's scorching. Right, so it's time to go home. I've drunk a bottle of water, 2 pints of Coke, and my head is starting to bang. So I think I am dehydrated. It's showing 35 degrees. I'm starting to feel a little lightheaded. So I think it's time to go home. It's just too hot. I must have sunk both of them pints of Coke in about 10 minutes. Just get a bit of, just go and get a bit of fresh air. Oh, that's nice. Nice bit of air. Ooh. Well, what a hot day. Let's have some tunes. Well, that's it. That's our little Friday ride out done. Still got some blue sky. We're still showing 30 degrees. I feel a bit better now. I've got some fresh air in me. I was feeling a little bit ropey back there. I think I was dehydrating fast. Sitting in that pub, we had no real shade. So I think I was absorbing all the sun rays available to me. But I'm feeling good now. A nice little gentle, easy ride home. Sometimes it is nice to get out on your own, because you're only setting your own pace. You're not trying to keep up with anybody. But let's get home, let's get the bike away. Kids have been to Blackpool today with a nan and granddad. So the wife's been working at home all day, remotely. Kids have been away. So it was a shame not to get out. Well, let's get back before the kids are back and World War III starts again. So thank you for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the first episode of the Normandy Tour. You might have already seen the second episode, you might not have. It all depends on when this video gets out. I might even be on holiday while this video is out. So if it is, you won't see a new video for at least 2 weeks. So ride safe and stay safe. Enjoy the summer. And I'll see you all on the next feed. Oosh! Boom shaka! Ding dong!